Little Black Box.
Hello, I'm Little Black Box.
I'll give you one hint what it is. Okay, that's enough.
I have in my hand one little black box. Box, black box. I can steal it. Anyway, this is very exciting. First, let's get back to good old Red One. Red One, I went out last week, as you saw, and flew Red One with the new retracts on it. And what I didn't realize, I had used a thinner plate to connect it and didn't think it was going to wobble like a lot. Well, in its position that it's in, it'll wobble like a milkshake woman walking down the block. I don't know what that means, but her milkshake brings all the boys to the yard. Anyway, so what we did was, this is a nice sticker. Actually came with these. Nice sticker platform to put these on. And I did retain my shelf for the transmitter, so I'm happy about that. However, none of that really matters. History now, because we have this black box. Curious, aren't you? This is the Mini X. Let's unbox it. I like when he put things in nice boxes. I don't know why. I do. Let's rip the plastic off. Very nice presentation, because presentation's everything. Yeah, I know. Where's the rest of it? So that's the flight controller. This is the smaller package. Got this from Buddy RC. They're selling them for about $149 for this package. I assume this is the GPS. I am not incorrect. Comes with a lovely set of wires. A brand new GPS stand. Put that back in there again. I assume this is the OSD. I really shouldn't be giving this away. I should make you guess. What's in this? Too late now. Okay, that would be the OSD. Once again, the Mini X and the GPS was underneath it. Voila, one GPS. Now, with the arrival of the Mini X, this marks the death of the APM 2.6. That's right. No more. Goodbye, 2.6. Red One's going to be a full-on, real quadcopter now. I learned a lot with APM. I'm not going to knock it down. I mean, without it, I wouldn't have learned half the crap that I know now. And it makes me more comfortable having this, knowing what I know now, than had I just bought it outright and went, I wonder what I do with it now. I did take Red One out and I flew it around, and we made sure the legs were not bobbling. You see the video here. And I walked around, and it surprisingly, it flew very well. You know, it just stayed right where it was supposed to stay. I'll check how the vibrations were. I don't think they were, they seemed to be minimized again. And it figures, right? So, that said, we will take Red One out for one more flight tomorrow, and then we'll start installing the Mini X. After we get done, we'll take it out and have some real flying time. The only challenge I have right now is this. And I think I'm okay because it's OpenTX, and it runs on FrySky, and I'm waiting the arrival of a couple FrySky S-Bus transmitters. And hopefully this all works out. Mighty Thor somewhere from an undisclosed location on someone's patio. I don't know whose it is, but it looked like a good spot to film. See ya!